Today we start with a convention or a notation used in this textbook, that is about the divisibility notation. We have written A divides B for ideals, A divides B for elements. Here we use A, the ideal divides ideal generated by B as A divides B. That means this is an ideal and this is an element. Even though these are of different parity, this is an ideal and this is an element, we use the notation as well, because this means ideal A divides the ideal generated by B. We know that whenever we divide, say, when we write this symbol A divides B, what is the meaning of this? B can be written as A into some C. In that sense, we write this, this is nothing but A, B can be ideal generated by B can be written as A into C, some C, some ideal C. So what is the meaning of this? This means we know that A contains its product, right? So this B, I'll write it as A contains A into C. That is nothing but B, ideal generated by B. Okay, so this shows that ideal generated by B is always contained in A. Okay, by this notation, that means B is always an element of A. Ideal, this ideal is contained in A means B is also an element of this ideal. Okay, the reverse part is trivial. When B divides A, then we can get this ideal is always contained in A. Okay, this can be converted to the divisibility criterion. So we can write it to this. We already discussed if this A contains this B, then A, we write this A divides B. So here we have this notation, A divides ideal generated by B. Okay, that is because A divides B, this is an element and this is an ideal, if and only if B is an element of A. That is what we have proved here. Now we can write P divides A into B, that can be translated to P divides AB. P divides AB means P divides ideal generated by A and ideal generated by B. In fact, this is ideal generated by AB and this is same as ideal generated by A into ideal generated by B. That we have already discussed in the earlier part of this algebraic number theory portion. So P divides AB means P divides ideal generated by A, that is P divides A, P divides ideal generated by B, that means P divides B. Okay, so we can use this notation as a divisibility notation of ideals. Now we can prove theorem 5.14. Let A be an ideal of O. It's a non-zero ideal. Then first result is, if n of A is a prime number, so prime, n of A is always a positive integer, if it is a prime number, then A is a prime ideal. Okay, so first we assume n of A, what is n of A? That is the cardinality of O by A. Okay, this is prime, it's a prime integer, then we need to prove that A is prime. For any non-zero ideal, A can be written as P1 into P2 into etc. Pk, product of prime ideals. Now, by equating norm on both sides, taking norm on both sides, you can write n of A equal to n of P1 etc. n of Pk using the multiplicative property. We know that this is a prime number. Let it be P. P is a prime number. N of A is a prime number. Then this will be, these are positive integers anyway. So this P divides this n of P1 into etc. n of pk. So p must divides one of them. Okay? So say n of p1. Without loss of generality, I take p divides this one. That implies p equal to n of p1 prime. Then we can get others are n of pk prime will be 1 for k is equal to 2, 2, 3, etc. Up to the I'll write this as R, where R is equal to 2 to etc. k. So this shows that n of pk equal to 1 implies cardinality of O by pk is equal to 1. This implies this pk are nothing but O. Okay. So this will be a contradiction, or you can replace the other prime ideal here with O. Yeah, that is this will be P1 into O into O into etc. O. So that will be P1 itself. So we can get A is a prime ideal. So whenever N of A is a prime, then the ideal itself is a prime ideal. This proves part A. For the B part, we assume N of A is equal. We take N of A as the cardinality of O by A by definition. I would say this N of A is a positive integer, say some number small n. That is the cardinality of O by A, ideal A. Okay. Now, if we choose any x belongs to O, we can say that when we add this or we collect this x and take N of A x, okay, or N x, that is always in A, the ideal A, clear? Because we can consider this O by A, this is nothing but collection of cosets of A. So if we take any element of this group as Ax, when we add this n times, you can get this is nx. Okay, when we operate any element of this group, its order of that group, then we can get the identity element. So this would become A, because any if we add any element of O by A with n numbers or cardinality of that group, we can get the identity element of that group. Identity element of the group is this one. So this implies nx is an element of A. N is nothing but n of A x. It's always an element of A. So this is true for every x in O by every x in O. Yeah? O contains 1. Therefore, this is also true for x equal to 1. So that implies N of A into 1 is always an element of A. That means N of A is always an element of A. This proves part B. For the part C, we need to prove that for C part, we need to prove that if A is a prime ideal, then N of A will be a power of a prime. Okay, for that we assume by 2, N of A is always an element of A. Okay, so this shows that N of ideal generated by N of A is always contained in A. In other way, we can write A divides N of A, or ideal generated by A, both are same. That is the notation we have just introduced. A divides this this number, that means ideal generated by this. Okay, so A divides this means N of A is always a positive integer, so that can be written as P1 raised to M1, P2 raised to M2, etc. PR raised to M1. So we can write this implies A divides ideal generated by P1 raised to M1, etc. ideal generated by PR raised to MR. Okay. So if we replace this this by the corresponding ideals using the notation we discussed just now, so we can get A divides this, right? Our assumption is this A is a prime ideal. Since A is a prime ideal, A should divide one of these factors, P1 raised to, say P1 raised to some M1. So we can write it as P1 into P1 into etc. Again P1, M times, M1 times. Our assumption is A divides one of the members of this. Without loss of generality, we can take P1 or some PI. Okay? So we can, if you write this as PI, so we can write it as pi raised to ideal generated by pi in mi times. This implies A should divide ideal generated by pi for some mi, or in our notation A divides pi. Okay, that's what we have written here. A divides pi for some rational prime pi. Okay, now if A divides two distinct primes, suppose we have a we have p and q, both are prime, such that a divides the ideal, a divides both the numbers. We can say that a should divide the GCD of, or we can write it as p, a divides p and a divides ideal generated by q. That implies both a contains both ideals p and q. So a contains p and q are elements of a, implies that any linear combination of p and q is always a member of a. So we can get u and v such that up plus vq is equal to 1, because p, gcd of p comma q is 1. Then you can find the integers u and v such that that is an element of that is equal to 1, but that is an element of a itself. So we can say that a contains 1. Clear? So then we will get a is equal to, oh, this is a contradiction, because a is a prime ideal, so hence it is a proper ideal. Therefore we can never get distinct primes. Both are contained in A, or A divides P and A divides Q for distinct prime is not possible. This shows that A divides PI for a unique prime number PI. Clear? Then we can say that N of A is always a power of a prime. Clear? N of A is always some P raised to alpha. Okay? We cannot get a distinct prime other than this P, which divides this number N of A. So this proves part C. Therefore this theorem says that whenever N of A is a prime, then A is prime ideal, but the converse need not be true. If A is a prime ideal, we can never assume that this N of A is a prime number but a power of prime. Okay, that is the remark on the theorem 5.14. So this is not an equivalent condition, it is not a characterization, but we have a one side implication for this. N of A is a prime implies A is a prime ideal. And we have 5.15, 5.16 are some examples and counterexamples for the for justifying the statement of theorem 5.14.